Alrighty, what we have now is Spike. Spike is a North American skunk, a striped skunk at that. Now, there are four different types of skunks found right here in Florida. We have the striped, which has the stripes on it. Then we have the spotted, which has little spots and they only get about yay big. And then we have the hooded, which looks very similar to this, but it's more of a single white stripe down their back, and it looks like somebody did their bangs for them. It sticks their bangs way out front. And then they have the hog nose, which nose is kind of turned up, giving it the name the hog nose skunk. All four of those are actually found here in Florida. Unfortunately, due to the overdevelopment of land and things like that, their numbers are decreasing. You don't see them as much as you used to. Now, Spike here came to us from somebody that had him for a pet. Most of our skunks have come to us. We have two of them as somebody's pet that didn't know what they were getting to. And in case you guys haven't noticed, I see a pattern forming here. People getting pets that just don't know what to do with them. Now this guy here, luckily he came to us. Problem is with skunks is there's no veterinary and no government that recognizes rabies shots and distemper shots and vaccinations on a skunk. So if you have a pet skunk and it happens to bite somebody, well, that person will probably have to go to the doctor and either get stitched up and looked at, possibly get some antibiotics in them. Unfortunately, that doctor is required by law to report the bite to the local law enforcement and local fish and game offices. Unfortunately, when that happens, animal control comes in and they take your skunk away and they will test it for rabies. No matter how many records of shots you have, they're still going to test it for rabies. And unfortunately, when you test an animal for rabies, you have to kill it. They actually have to test its brain to see if it has rabies. So that means that that animal dies senselessly because you wanted a cute pet. To me, cute is a four-letter word. You should never buy a pet just because it's cute. Get an animal or a pet that you know you can take care of and it can be a companion for you. And I'll be honest with you, skunks don't make the very greatest of companions. They got a couple of things going for them that aren't that great. For one, they got super long nails designed for ripping trees apart, for eating grubs and ants. And see that? Whew. I'd hate to get scratched by them in the middle of the night. Not like a dog that rolls up next to your feet. He also has a set of teeth on him that are unbelievable. His teeth are very sharp. And when he bites, he doesn't bite once, he bites a lot. And he will chow down on you pretty good if he bites you. Now, the thing he has, along with sharp nails, long nails, good sharp teeth, he has very poor eyesight. He can't see too good. So your toes in the middle of the night underneath the blanket, if he tries to coil up next to you, look surprisingly close to hot dogs. Unless you're a girl and have red nail polish on, and then they look like strawberries. Both things that skunks love to eat. So you might get a little snip from him in the middle of the night. So not necessarily the world's greatest pet. They do have an excellent sense of smell and hearing. But let's talk a little bit about their smell, right? Everybody's heard about skunk spraying. Now, do you guys know why our skunk hasn't sprayed Sarah yet?
Because I'm pretty.
Because she's pretty. You said it, not me. That kind of has something to do with it. Of course, he has bad eyesight, so that may just be what's going for too. But we've de-skunkified him. Skunks have two glands on the backside of their backside, and they point at each other. It's two separate chemicals, and when they get upset enough to use them, they will squeeze those glands, and it will shoot out two separate chemicals. They intersect about 2 feet from the skunk. When they meet each other, it's a chemical reaction, and it's almost like a cloud, which will cover about a 10 by 10 area, which means pretty much the whole camera crew right now, they'd be sleeping on the couch for the night. Because tomato soup baths, they don't work. Last I heard, that was actually made up by a tomato farmer that was having a bad sales week, and he let a bunch of skunks go into town. And he told everybody that tomato juice would make the smell go away, so they bought all his tomatoes. Actually, I don't know if that's true, but it sounded good, didn't it? It's almost believable. Now, skunks will give us warnings before they will use that spray. First warning is just by looking at him. He'll take that tail here, and he'll flash that tail up in the air, and he'll show off all them nice bright colors. Scientists and nerds call it aposematic coloring. I call it bright colors mean danger, warning, stay away. If you notice, most of our lights and stuff we have that tell us to stay away, they blink yellow and bright colors. It's kind of the same thing with this guy. He's showing you them white, bright colors, and that heavy contrast means just leave me alone. Now, if that doesn't work, he's going to stomp his feet on the ground, because maybe you're blind and you can't see him. So he'll stomp his feet on the ground, and he'll try and kind of like throwing a temper tantrum. That way you'll hear him. Now, if that doesn't work, well, third strike and you're skunked. What he's going to do is he actually has been taking lessons with the Blue Man crew at Cirque du Soleil, and he actually does a handstand and puts his back end over his front end, and that's how he squirts you. So that way he doesn't have to take the time of turning around. It's pretty wild to see. Of course, I don't like to see it too much because that means that I'm getting skunked and I have to sleep outside for the night, or actually for a week. They say that you actually have to wear the smell off. That means for about a week, you're going to take vacation time because your boss is not going to let you at work. And once the smell goes away, well, people might still be afraid to come near you, that it's still going to be around.